Almost a quarter of women who responded have missed school or work because they couldn't afford sanitary products, according to a new KidsCan survey. It's a topic that's not often talked about, but information like this is eye-opening to the level of poverty that some Kiwis are facing. For more, we're joined by KidsCan founder and chief executive, Julie Chapman. Good morning.
Good morning.
So can you just tell us a bit more about the survey?
Yeah, so I think we put a survey out and we were quite surprised that around 5,000 women actually responded to that. It was certainly a topic that many women and girls are passionate about, and what it revealed to us is that a lot of women and girls are having to make choices of whether to put food on the table, whether to pay for power, those sorts of things, as opposed to buying sanitary items, and those choices are hard to make.
Do you think that the survey is an accurate representation of the issue?
Yeah, I think what we've learnt is it's a surprise that there were so many people that responded. Almost 30% of the young women, girls that responded, had said they'd miss school or work because they couldn't afford to buy these items. And I think, you know, in a country that prides itself on gender equality, this is one of those really hidden things that we don't talk about much that is actually a barrier to that.
Because obviously women or girls don't choose to have their period every single month. Is there an equivalent for men? And like, is there a product that they need and they have to have that they can't go without, but is quite expensive?
I can't think of one off the top of my head. I mean, I guess men need to shave, but they can go without that, right? They don't need to do that. They can grow a beard. For women, that's not a choice. You need that product every month. And let's be clear, this is actually about poverty across the board. So what we're seeing is material hardship, missing out on the basics, and then a rise in the need for these types of items that they just can't afford.
But they need, and it's ridiculous that it's called a luxury item. I just find that completely astounding. How can we fix this?
Look, I think the first thing that our priority at KidsCan is to make sure that the people that really need this support, and that's the girls in low decile schools across the country, get access to those products for free. We will have sent out 20,000 packets or more by the end of the year. We want to do more investigation into this because we want to make sure that every girl, particularly in those lower socioeconomic areas, has access to that, because one of the best ways out of poverty is to get to school and learn.
Exactly. What do you think we could do? We could maybe also take tax away or even subsidise like we do for condoms?
Yeah, I think Countdown's been great. They've made some moves to actually lower the price. We could make moves like Australia to take the GST off. I don't know how difficult that would be in terms of our current tax system, but certainly I think the first priority is to make sure that the girls who need it most are getting access to them.
Thank you very much for your time this morning. Julie Chapman from KidsCan.
Thank you.